Thank you. your kind cooperation.
Nature is a beautiful creation of God, a precious gift to all of us living on earth. It is the art of the earth, a source of and an open book for all people of the world to read. We only need to look, feel, smell, creator. Nature is full of wonders and gifts for us. It has the power to provide true joy, goodness, and happiness. Let us cherish and harmonious life, as well as to see the Creator in all His creation, to love and serve Him, who is, you are my God. I will exalt you and praise your name, for in perfect faithfulness you have done wonderful things. Things plan praises from all people, for all times, as He is our Creator. Here are our students praising God Almighty through their dance, Sandesha Padam Namo.
प्रपंच चैतन्य सारे
For there is great power in giving honor and welcoming him into our midst. We also praise God, from whom all blessings flow, for life is better when we praise God. There is music in the air, music all around us, and the world is full of it. The choir will now present the welcome song.
Thank you.
Light represents God's presence. It dispels the darkness and illuminates. Light and love are the essence of God, and therefore our being and everything that exists. May the darkness of ignorance be swept away by the dawn of self-realization. I now request our dignitaries to take their seats. A true artist is not the one who is inspired, but the one who inspires others. We have an inspiring personality who is well known for his hard work, dedication, sincerity, and excellence, and who is none other than our very own headmaster, Reverend Father Tuma Uday Bhaskar, to kindly come forward and present the welcome address.
The best way to predict your future is to create it. Esteemed Chief Guest, His Eminence Cardinal Pola Anthony, Archbishop of Hyderabad and Chairman of HACE, Guest of Honor Monsignor Y. Balashore Reddy, Vice Chairman of HACE, Lieutenant Colonel K. Veerashekhar, Reverend Fathers, Sisters, Parents and my dear students, good evening to one and all and a hearty welcome to our annual day celebration Nathura 2023. It is with great pleasure I stand before you today as the headmaster of this esteemed institution to celebrate our school annual day. This is just a day, but a celebration of long achievements in a year, a time in the glory of our triumphs. The annual day holds a special place in our hearts as it is a testimony to the hard work, perseverance, and dedication we have put in throughout the year. It's a reflection of the vibrant educational and co-curriculum accomplishments we have achieved together, the commendable performance of our students in academics, sports, and extracurricular activities are a testimony to our school's holistic development approach. Today, we celebrate their hard work and dedication to school. He who puts his soul and heart in uplifting others attains dignity. Yes, it is none other than His Eminence Cardinal Pola Anthony, our chief guest of the day. He is a true leader and visionary. His Eminence is a rare gem, a true treasure to be treasured and celebrated. In him are great qualities of heart and mind, and a heart that wants to serve and do good to the utmost people whoever approaches him. A gracious and pleasant personality, simple to the core, that whoever meets him find themselves at ease. With sentiments of gratitude, I appreciate his availability to be in our midst this evening in spite of his heavy schedule. Thank you for accepting our invitation, for your presence, giving added joy to this celebration, and hearty welcome to your Eminence. A warm welcome to our guest of honor, Monsignor Erva Balashore Reddy, whose vision and dedication has led to remarkable achievements. His wealth of knowledge has always guided us to move forward in the path of success. Welcome you, Monsignor. We also have in our midst Lieutenant Colonel Veerashekhar, who has made a significant impact in his field with unwavering commitment to excellence, inspiring many those around him and won many laurels, and he is in our midst. A cordial welcome to you, dear sir. I also welcome Reverend Father Innaya, the Treasurer of HACE, who made available to come and to be in our presence, the Principal of St. Mary's High School. Welcome you, dear Father. Our teachers have been backbone of this comprehensive and multi-phase growth. They have been the guiding stars leading our students towards knowledge, wisdom and promising future. Their commitment and relentless efforts have always been the best for our students. I would like to take this opportunity to express my profound thanks towards our diligent teachers, teaching and non-teaching staff, and welcome our retired teachers, alumni, Reverend Father M. Pratap, the parish priest, and all the parishioners of St. John Marie Vianney Church. Parents, your support and cooperation has been instrumental in our journey. Your belief in us has always helped us to achieve our goals and set new benchmarks. We value your trust and assure you that we will be coming to strive for excellence in the coming academic years. And a hearty welcome to you all. I believe that our school is not just a place for formal education, but a space where students grow and evolve as individuals. It is a place where their inner potentiality is nurtured and where they learn the values of respect, integrity and responsibility. As I look forward for the coming days, I am filled with joy and aspiration. I am confident that our students will continue to strive for excellence and make the most of the opportunities present to them and make us proud with their accomplishments. A hearty welcome to you all and have a pleasant evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. To mark this happy occasion, we request our headmaster, Reverend Father Tuma Uday Bhaskar, to honor our esteemed chief guest, His Eminence Cardinal Pula Anthony, with a sapling, shawl, and a gift as a token of respect and appreciation. Kindly give them a huge round of applause.
Most Reverend Dr. Pula Anthony, the first Telugu bishop to be chosen as cardinal from Archdiocese of Hyderabad. His Eminence Dr. Pula Anthony was ordained priest for the Diocese of Kadapa on 20th February 1992 at St. Mary's Cathedral, Mariapuram, Kadapa, and has served ministry in the Diocese of Kadapa in various capacities. He also acted as resident priest at St. Joseph's Catholic Church, St. Joseph, Kalamazoo Diocese, USA in the year 2001-2002, and associate priest at St. Genevieve Catholic Church, Archdiocese of Chicago. He was also a coordinator for CFCA, Secretary for Education Society, Deputy Manager RCM Schools, Diocese of Kadapa, and editor of CFCA Samachara Lekha. He was appointed as Bishop of Kurnool on 8th February 2008. His main motto is good news to the poor. His Eminence believes that no child should be deprived of education because of poverty. He also promoted Panchasutra for all-round development of the Kurnool Diocese. He has also produced Telugu devotional audio cassettes, wrote lyrics, and has composed songs too. 2017 was a special year of grace for Most Reverend Dr. Pula Anthony as he completed 25 years of joyful and fruitful ministry in the vineyard of the Lord as a priest. He has also rendered his services as a chairman of Andhra Pradesh Social Service Society, Sikh Village Campus, Secretariat for TCBC Priest Community, Jeevan Institute of Printing Press. Under his able leadership and guidance, the construction and renovation of new churches, presbyteries, institutions, etc. were completed in Kurnool Diocese. On 19th November 2020, Bishop Most Reverend Dr. Pula Anthony was appointed as the new Metropolitan Archbishop of Hyderabad by His Holiness Pope Francis. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a hearty round of applause and welcome His Eminence Cardinal Pola Anthony. Most Reverend Dr.
As a touching gesture of honor and admiration, now it is time to express our gratitude. I request Reverend Father Thuma Uday Bhaskar to felicitate our guest of honors, Monsignor Reverend Father Balashao Reddy, with a shawl.
To his credit, spiritual orientation course, philosophical studies, regency and theological studies from St. John's Regional Seminary, Hyderabad. Father was ordained as priest on 9th April 1991.
And Ambrose, sir, to present a sapling and a gift as a token of appreciation.
Monsignor Balashauri has held several appointments and assignments as assistant parish priest, principal, rector, dean for Hyderabad Deanery, vicar general of Archdiocese of Hyderabad, Vice Chairman of Hyderabad Archdiocese Educational Institutes and member of the Diocesan Consultors. Father has written lyrics and produced many devotional albums. Father authored a book, Enduring Journey, History of St. Mary's Basilica, released at the time of Quarto Septennial celebrations of St. Mary's Basilica. Father received awards like Vidya Siromani from Dr. P.V. Rangarao, the then Educational Minister of Andhra Pradesh, and has a diploma in Karnataka Classical Music Certificate with Sangeeta Visharada. Father Yerava Balashauri has to his credit spiritual orientation course, philosophical studies, regency and theological studies from St. John's Regional Seminary, Hyderabad. Father was ordained as priest on 9th April 1991 at St. Ignatius Church, Gagilapur, Hyderabad. Monsignor Balashauri has held several appointments and assignments as assistant parish priest.
As a token of our heartfelt appreciation and gratitude, I now request our principal to honor our esteemed guest, Lieutenant Colonel K. Veerashekar, with a shawl.
Lieutenant Colonel K. Veerashekar completed his TRG at Officers Training Academy, Chennai in 1997. Later, he was commissioned into Regiment of Artillery in 255 Field Regiment.
Martha teacher will present a sapling and a gift to our guest.
Veerashekar has served for 26 years in the Army. He participated in Operation Rhino 1997, Operation Vijay Kargil War 1999. In UN mission, he participated in Operation Rockberry, Operation Thunderbolt, Operation Kukri in 2000 and Operation Parakram 2002. He served in various regimental and staff appointments, including training in charge of Indian Army Wrestling and Archery Team in Army Sports Institute, Pune. He was also a part of the service team in World Military Games, Macedonia. Currently, Lieutenant Colonel K. Veerashekar is on study leave pursuing his Master's in Journalism and Mass Communication from St. Joseph's Degree and PG College, King Koti, Hyderabad.
I now request Reverend Father Uday Bhaskar to felicitate Reverend Father P. Innaya. Vandana Devi teacher will now present a sapling. I request His Eminence Cardinal Pola Anthony to unveil the new academic calendar.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Eminence. May I now request our dignitaries to retreat to their seats. God can be found in nature, in animals, birds, and the environment. The choir will now enthrall us with a song.
Survival. Let's put our hands together and welcome our beautiful tiny tots who are here to create awareness on the importance of wildlife in the form of dance mode. So let's cheer them up and welcome them.
Super performance in spreading the message of water conservation to everyone, as each and every drop counts. So it's time to confer our annual accomplishment of small and big victories. Bala Jyotika, our head girl, and her team will present a brief agenda on school presentation.
Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Panel, respected Headmaster, Reverend Father Devaskar, Reverend Fathers, dedicated sisters, dear parents, well wishes and friends. Good evening and a very warm welcome to each one of you gathered here. I am Bala Jyotika, the head girl. Feel elated to stand here along with my friends to present before you the year of opportunities that was provided to fulfill all that we dream and enhance the overall development of the students. We render our grateful thanks to God Almighty for being with us in all our endeavors and for leading us through the year 2023 with his strength, power and love. Established in the year 1942, St. Philomena High School has a long tradition of excellence in providing quality education to girls, giving them the opportunity to achieve their full potential in a conducive environment supported by dedicated teachers. Today, we proudly recollect and celebrate the efforts of our alma mater for inscribing her deep mark of excellence in the field of education for the past 81 long years. Our school motto, Love Conquers All, has a powerful message for every student who is educated at St. Philomena High School. It testifies our belief that our students will meet the challenges of the future by developing into an ethical, articulate, young women confident in their individual talent and seeking to use them for the benefit of all. With such objectives, the school reopened after summer vacation on 12th June 2023 to prepare our hearts and minds to acquire knowledge and to cultivate the feeling of fellowship and togetherness. As we share the early updates of activities, we take the modesty to say that we did our best as we have planned, and we are proud of our students and teachers who have strived hard to achieve beyond expectations under the able leadership of our visual headmaster, Reverend Father Tuma Uday Bhaskar. Sara will now continue with the report.
Our school is fully equipped with massive and aesthetic building structure, well ventilated and spacious classrooms with CCTV cameras, well equipped science labs with latest apparatus and materials to foster hands-on learning and experimentation. Our computer lab is equipped with technologically advanced computer systems to ensure students are well versed with current technological trends. 10 computers with high configuration were added by our management, Hyderabad Archdiocese Educational Society.
A well-stocked space promoting reading and research with a lot of books, journals and digital resources. School app helped in bringing more transparency and enhanced communication between parents, teachers and school itself. Parents can keep a real-time track of the status of the child for fee status and school circulars, etc. Self-belief and hard work will always earn success. This was very much true in the case of our teachers and students who joined to secure success, as academic excellence was evident with a remarkable 98% pass rate in SSA public examination. Zohar Nas and Konda Vaishnavi secured 10 points each in SSA public examination. A new day starts with a new belief, strength and endless possibilities. Daily morning prayer and assembly in our school holds immense importance and starts the day on a cool and calm note. Morning assembly plays a vital role in bringing everyone together, creating a positive environment that fosters unity and cooperation. Each class conducts assemblies with prayer song, prayer, news, inspirational thoughts, value-based skills to imbibe the skills for life.
and also subject-wise exhibitions are held periodically for every assessment. After each assessment, the students who have secured top positions in their respective classes are awarded the first-in-class badges by RHL. Now, Ketana will go ahead with the report.
Alone, we can do so little. Together, we can do so much. The primary objective of grouping the staff and students into houses is to foster team spirit among students, not only through co-scholastic areas, but also through curricular activities. The groups of St. Philomena High School, named after the saints, are Bartholomeans, the Jerosians, the Mother Theresians, the Goretians. Life is a celebration of passionate colors. Being different gives the world color. All the children from the KG department, along with their teachers, were dressed beautifully with colored attires to mark the occasion. The motive of celebration of Color Concept Day is to create awareness in children on different colors and to develop psychomotor and cognitive skills. Now, Samia will continue with the report.
Educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. Aristotle. True to the same, we have a band of dedicated, hardworking, cooperative and committed staff who seek to draw out best in every child by the power of perseverance based on love and kindness. They take the role of parenting the child and giving them the right kind of wisdom and developing a positive attitude and personality. We applaud Selvi teacher, present person attendance this year and congratulate Jyotika teacher and GNP auntie for their successful completion of 25 years in our institution. And we also would like to express our gratitude to Stella auntie who would be retiring this year. It is the teacher that makes the change, not the mere classroom. Teaching is an ongoing process. Staying updated is the key to success in any field, especially in the field of education. Our teachers participate in a wide range of orientation and enrichment program to enhance knowledge of their subject and keep them abreast with changing patterns in education. Counseling is provided by our teachers who make a profound impact in our lives. It helps us to identify our strengths and weaknesses, which aid us in making better decisions, to navigate challenges, develop life skills, to cope up with stress and anxiety, and build healthy relationships with our peers, teachers, and family members. School takes special care in imparting value-based education with the focus in molding the character of children and in spiritual development. Catechism classes are conducted for all the Catholic students to enable them to grow in the knowledge of God Almighty. Being a Catholic institution, we have various spiritual activities beginning with Holy Spirit Eucharistic celebration in June, followed by Holy Mass every month with different themes. The school management committee comprises a few parents and teachers along with the headmaster to enable the functioning of the school to be more manageable, discuss problems any related to students or the school and receive valuable advice and assistance in times of need. Now Akshaya will carry forward with the report.
To take part is what counts in competition, and lessons of victory and defeat are what we get in return. Our school environment was sufficiently created through inter-school and inter-house competitions periodically for the primary, middle and high school. The primary school participated in 14 different competitions. The middle school also participated in 14 different competitions as well, whereas the high school participated in 17 competitions with lot of enthusiasm and interest. Hannah Sharon will now update us with the school celebrations.
Celebration sharing the happy moments together and spreading joy all around is a vital aspect of St. Philomena's. Yoga is a mirror to look at ourselves from within. Our school celebrated Yoga Day, which serves as a global platform to raise awareness about various benefits of practicing yoga. In commitment to environmental conservation, our school celebrated Arita Harum, an eco-friendly initiative in July on a grand scale, emphasizing the importance and the need to conserve greenery in our country. Contributing to environmental conservation, our students participated in recycling initiatives by donating their old textbooks and notebooks. St. Philomena school feast was celebrated to pay our devotion to our beloved patroness. National festivals are held to inculcate integrity and respect for India's rich heritage and culture, and religious festivals with a divine message of love. Teachers' Day was celebrated with vigor and vitality to pay our honor and our tribute to our teachers. To mark the importance of Children's Day, games and a cultural program was organized by our teachers. Young people are the leaders of tomorrow. They are the leaders of today and tomorrow. Invest Teacher Ceremony, the most prestigious ceremony of St. Philomena High School 2022-23, was held with great dignity, degree of earnestness, passion and zeal to bestow upon the students the ability to be the future leaders of our nation. Our headmaster also encourages them to put in honest efforts for every endeavor and to be an inspiration to others. We all play different instruments, but together we shall make beautiful music. The school band's introduction is the most prestigious thing, and we are very much elated to be a part of it. The band is headed by Mr. Vijay Bhaskar, the band master. The band played at every flag hoisting ceremony and in West Teacher ceremony. Not only has it taught us the values of hard work, but also allowed us to become a leader within by creating positive influences in our lives. Fiona will now continue with the report.
Orientation program was conducted, which served as an important interface for the students, parents and school authorities to connect and plan for the upcoming academic year. Career guidance session was conducted for class 10 students on how to choose a perfect career. A session was taken up by the Gandhinagar Police Department to enlighten the students on cybercrime. Health is the greatest of human blessings. Good healthcare helps create a good foundation, growth and development of an individual. The school health checkup program invests in providing quality health and hygiene to the school children and teachers to lead a healthy and sound life. Deworming tablets were administered to the students by the government on the National Deworming Day. Treasuring the precious gift of life of our students and teachers, our school has availed the opportunity provided by the qualified doctors from the government hospital for the general medical checkup with the issue of medicines for the same. Now, Janavi would continue the report.
If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more and become more, you are a leader. Join Quincy Adams. The aim of introducing NCC at our school level is to provide leadership in all walks of our life, to build self-confidence for the service of the nation with unity and discipline. The cadets practice every Tuesday and Friday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. and develop the skills necessary for the civic competence. We thank our NCC mentor, Mrs. Devika, for her dedicated services. The cadets attended a camp at St. Francis Degree College, Begumpet. They participated in various activities. Hansika of 9th grade secured the first position in solo dance and Tejashmini secured the third place in Coco. A picnic is a state of mind and can be made anywhere. School picnics are a wonderful, cherished part of every student's academic life. Invigorating outings keep the students motivated and charged up. Picnics not only diverts us from regular agenda, rather adds a touch of variety, charm and refreshment to our lives. Our school has also conducted picnics for us as they are the perfect source for rejuvenation and also a perfect way to relax and enjoy the nature. Adi Janavi will continue with the report.
It's not about being the best, it's about being better than you were yesterday. Games, sports and physical fitness occupy a place of importance in our curriculum. Our school has always been keen in taking initiatives to get the best in sports arena under the able guidance of our mentor Mrs. Bhavani. Physical fitness plays an important role in child's growth and how well the students perform academically. Sports also inculcate the spirit of positive challenges, sense of competitive spirit, cooperation, confidence and team spirit to prepare us for the life ahead. In Coco and Kabaddi in the under-17 category, B. Vaishnavi of grade 10 got selected for district level. Tanushree of grade 10 got selected for state level. In Coco, in the under-14 category, Grishma, Vedashree and Ashwata of grade 8 got selected for district level. In handball competition, Niharika and Saravi of grade 8 got selected for nationals. In football, Manogya and Manaswini of grade 8 got selected for national level. Tanushree of grade 10 participated in karate championship and won the following medals. In CMKCL Mega Cup, she secured gold medal. In South India Karate Championship, she was awarded bronze medal. In Open Hyderabad Karate Championship, she won silver medal. In National Level Karate and Kung Fu Championship, she bagged gold medal. Pujashree of grade 6 participated participated in South India Karate Championship and won gold medal. In Open Hyderabad Karate Championship, she secured silver medal. This report will be concluded by Bhuvneshwar.
It is rightly said, the secret of all great undertaking is hard work and self-reliance. As we reflect on our 82-year journey, we are filled with gratitude and pride for what Sun Phenomena School stands for. We are confident that with the continued support of our dedicated staff, brilliant students and the larger school community, our legacy of excellence will continue for many more years to go. Our school is committed to fostering a conducive learning environment with a blend of academic, extracurricular and professional development programs. We aim to holistically nurture our students and staff, ensuring excellence in education and character development. Standing up by our mission, we would continue to keep reaching for the stars. Thank you.
Thank you, Bala and the team, for presenting the school report.
We will now delve into an enchanting, rhythmic, lively music and expressive facial expressions to present ourselves. Here we come.
Thank you, children, for the beautiful and elegant movements which kept us spellbound.
చాలా ప్రాచుర్యం పొందింది. తరతరాలుగా ప్రజా చైతన్యంలో ఈ కళ ఎంతో కీలకమైన పాత్ర పోషిస్తుంది. ఇందులో ఒకరు కథ చెప్తూ ఉంటారు, మరో ఇద్దరు రెండు వైపుల్లా నిలబడి వంత పాడుతూ ఉంటారు. కథ చెప్పేవాడిని కథకుడు అని, వంత పాడేవారిని వంతలు అంటారు. కథకుని చేతిలో తంబూర ఉంటుంది, కాబట్టి ఈ కథను బుర్ర కథ అంటారు. యేసుప్రభు తన శిష్యులకు ప్రబోధించిన విత్తు అని ఉపమానమును బుర్రకథ రూపంలో మా విద్యార్థులు ప్రదర్శించబోతున్నారు. కథలో కథకురాలు యక్షిత, వంతలు భువనేశ్వరి మరియు ఆశిని. వీరిని చప్పట్లతో ఆహ్వానిద్దాం.
సృష్టికర్తను ముందుగా తలచి శిష్యులకు బోధించిన విత్తువాని ఉపమానం కేవలం కథ కాదు, ఇది మన సంఘానికి, సంఘ సభ్యులకు వారి ఇహలోక పరలోక చింతలను గురించి చెప్పిన నిజమైన కథ, నిత్యమైన కథ, విలువైన కథ. జాగ్రత్తగా వినండి.
సై సై
దైవ కుమారుడే పశువుల పాకలో పుట్టెను మన కోసం
తన్నాన తాన
మరి అయ్యేసేపు ముద్దుల తనయుడు మన బాల యేసయ్యా
తన్నాన తాన
లోకరక్షకుడు తన ప్రాణాలను ఘనంగా పెట్టాడు.
అక్క, ఆ ఉపమానం మాకు చెప్పవు.
అమ్మలారా, అయ్యలారా, మరీ శ్రద్ధగా వినండి. ఆ దైవాంశ సంభూతుడు వివరించిన విత్తువాని ఉపమానం.
విత్తువాని ఉపమానం తగదా తగిట తగ తరిగిట తరిగిట
అనగనగా ఒక రైతు తన పొలంలో విత్తనాలు చల్లుతుండగా
చల్లుతుండగా
త్రోవ పక్క కొన్ని పడ్డాయి
సై,
రాళ్ళల్లో మరికొన్ని పడ్డాయి
సై,
ముళ్ళల్లో ఇంకొన్ని పడ్డాయి
సై,
మంచి నేలలో కొన్ని పడ్డాయి
సై. తరిగిట తరిగిట జం తరిగా.
అక్క, కథ చెప్పమంటే విత్తనాలు
అక్కడ ఇక్కడ ఎక్కడో పడ్డాయంటావు, కాస్త వివరంగా చెప్పవు.
ఏముంది, రైతు ఇంటికి వెళ్ళుంటాడు.
నీవు కాస్త ఆప్తావా అక్క, నీవు చెప్పు.
ఆ తర్వాత త్రోవ పక్క పడ్డ విత్తనాలను పక్షులెత్తుకెళ్ళాయి, రాళ్లలో పడ్డ విత్తనాలు వేరులేక ఎండిపోయాయి, ముళ్ళలోని విత్తనాలు అణచివేయబడ్డాయి. మంచినీళ్ళలోని విత్తనాలు ఏమైనవో తెలుసా, 30 ఇంతలు 60 ఇంతలు 100 ఇంతలు 100 ఇంతలు ఫలించాయి. దేవుని వాక్యం, విత్తువాడు ఆ దేవుడు. 4 రకాల నీళ్ళు మానవ హృదయాలు. ఈ 4 రకాల మానవ మనస్తత్వ హృదయాలను మీరే కల్లారా చూడండి.
యెషయా గ్రంథం 55వ అధ్యాయం వచనములు 10-11. వాన, మంచు ఆకాశము నుండి దిగివచ్చి అచ్చటికి మరలిపోక భూమిని తడిపి దాని మీద పైరుని మొలిపించి పంట పండించును. నా నోటి నుండి వెలువడు వాక్కు కూడా ఈ రీతిగానే ఉండును. పిల్లలు, దేవుని వాక్యం శక్తి కలది, సత్యంలో నడిపిస్తుంది, నీతి మార్గంలో నడిపిస్తుంది. దేవుని వాక్యాన్ని విని గ్రహించి ఆచరిస్తే జీవితంలో సంతోషంగా ఉంటాము.
పిల్లలు, మీరు ఈ మాటలు ఎల్లప్పుడు గుర్తించుకుంటూ దేవుని వాక్యానుసారం జీవించాలి.
కాలచక్రం తిరుగుతుండగా 4 కొడుకులు దేశంలోని వివిధ ప్రాంతాల్లో స్థిరపడ్డారు. వృద్ధాప్యంలో ఉన్న తల్లిదండ్రులను చూడడానికి 4 కొడుకులు వచ్చారు.
అమ్మా, నానా, మీరు ఎలా ఉన్నారు?
మాదేముంది నాయన, అంతా అయిపోయింది, మీరెలా ఉన్నారు?
మీ అందరిని ఒకేసారి ఇలా చూడటం చాలా ఆనందంగా ఉంది. మీ భార్యలు, పిల్లలు ఎలా ఉన్నారు?
అంత క్షేమమే నానా.
కుమారులారా, మీ జీవితాలు ఎలా ఉన్నాయి? సంతోషంగా ఉన్నారా? చిన్నవాడా, ఇటురా, ఇప్పటికైనా నీ జీవితం సాఫీగా సాగుతుందా?
ఉద్యోగం లేదు, తాగుడు వ్యసనాన్ని మార్చుకోలేకపోతున్నాను. జీవితంలో సమస్యల మీద సమస్యలు, రోడ్డు మీద బతుకులా ఉంది నా జీవితం.
అయ్యో, రెండోవాడా, ఇలారా, నీ జీవితం ఎలా ఉంది?
ఏదో అలా ఉంది అమ్మా. ఉద్యోగం సరిగ్గా లేదు, ఉద్యోగం వచ్చినట్టే వస్తుంది, మళ్ళీ పోతుంది. 2 నెలలు పనిచేస్తే 3 నెలలు ఖాళీ, ఇది నా పరిస్థితి. నా జీవితం రాతినీద వలె కఠినంగా ఉంది.
అయ్యయ్యో, మూడోవాడా, నీ జీవితం ఎలా ఉంది?
పర్వాలేదు అమ్మా, ఏనాటికి ఆనాడు అన్నట్లు ఉంది నా పరిస్థితి. పిల్లలు వృద్ధుల్లోకి రాలేకపోతున్నారు, ముళ్ళ పొదల వల్లే ఉంది నా జీవితం.
పెద్దవాడా, నీ జీవితం ఎలా ఉంది?
అమ్మా, నేను నా కుటుంబం చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉన్నాను. పిల్లలు ఉన్నత చదువులు చదువుతున్నారు, మాకు ఏ సమస్యలు లేవు, ఉన్న దాంట్లో ఆనందంగా జీవిస్తున్నాం. దేవుని వాక్యానుసారం జీవిస్తూ మా పిల్లలను కూడా అదే బాటలో నడిపిస్తున్నాం.
చూశారా, మీ నలుగురి జీవితాలు విత్తువాణి ఉపమానంలోని నాలుగు రకాల నీళ్ళ వలె ఉన్నాయి.
such a beautiful performance. Wasn't that amazing? Music is the medicine of the mind. The choir will now sing Aaya Masi. Recognizes, appreciates and values the efforts of teachers and the SSC toppers for their hard work and dedication. May I now request our chief guest, His Eminence Cardinal Pula Anthony, accompanied by our principal, Reverend Father Thumma Uday Bhaskar, to come onto the dais and honor them. our NCC cadets will escort our guest.
Respected Reverend Monsignor Y. Balachowdy, the Vice Chairman of CASE, Reverend Father Inaya, the Treasurer of CASE, respected IT Colonel Shekhar Garu and his Mrs., Reverend Father Uday Bhaskar, the Principal, dear Reverend Fathers, sisters, the parents, my beloved children. Let me congratulate Father Uday, the teachers, parents and all of you on the occasion of your school annual day. Secondly, I would like to appreciate you for choosing this topic, Natura, which is nature. Very nicely you portrayed some of the items like save animals, save earth, save farmer, save family, save trees, etc., etc. The world is in danger, they say. Not simply say, but it is very, very serious. I hope some of you or all of you might have paid attention to the G20. The changing scenario of the world, our regions and the cosmopolitan cities and the rural villages are no exception. And right now, the coastal belt and Tamil Nadu and Kerala, we are seeing the floods and the suffering people. There are five basic elements of nature we know very well. The earth, water, fire, air and space. An Indian philosophy, our human body also is composed of five elements. We know the first one is Agni, the fire. The second one is wind, which is Vayu. Third one is Dharti, which is earth. Fourth is Jal, water. Fifth, Akash, the space. My dear friends, today, as Saint Philomena celebrates the annual day, along with them, all of us, let us contemplate on this. Just two points I would like to share. The first one is, darkness cannot dispel darkness. But whereas the light dispels the darkness, the light which we have lighted just beginning of our program. My dear brothers and sisters, today education has so much of importance. Education is here which we all will answer to acquire knowledge. It is not only acquiring the knowledge, but also it dispels the darkness in our mind and heart. The darkness that is in our mind and heart. This is, we need to understand. To understand the life, the situations and the challenges, we need education. Education brings a change in society, change within ourselves and within each student. This education should help us to dispel the darkness of selfishness. Just one point I would like to share with you is that the society and in our individual life, we know the experience of ego. That is the one letter I. So that I should lead us to find we. Manamandaramu okkate. We know the beautiful country, our nation India. We have so many languages, so many religions, so many other cultural activities which we see, which we have witnessed in the on the stage just now. That's why our country widely known as university, unity in diversity. That's what G20 told us. They have decided certain things, and one thing we should never forget is Vasudhaika Kutumbakam.
Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us understand the importance of knowledge. It's not only for acquiring knowledge, but also to esteem ourselves, to excel in our society, and to work for the excellence, especially for the integral development of the society. The second aspect I wanted to share with you is the truthfulness. Satyame vajayate. This is to understand the truth will lead us into the right path. The truth will help us to create a just society. The truthfulness which will lead us in the values of the society. It is not about ahimsa, it is not about war, but as human beings, we are here to lead ourselves to the peace and help others also to find peace and to live in peace. The concept we know about is live and let live. Jeevinchu itarulanu jeevinchani. Therefore, with these two thoughts, my dear brothers and sisters, especially the management of the school, his team, the principal, the teachers and parents, and my dear children, we all should begin the revolution for a change. It is not that as we are some 100 years ago, but it is for the change. That's why manamandaramu okareki okaramu todu untu nenu saitam ani nenu saitam samajaniki manchi cheyutaku I am ready. I am Indian. I am a student. I am a teacher. I am a professor. I am a priest. I am a religious men and women and citizens of society. Nenu saitam సమాజానికి అన్నటువంటి ఆ శ్లోగాన్ని మన జీవితాల్లో అన్వయింప చేసుకొని ఆ విధంగా ముందుకు వెళ్ళవలసినటువంటి ఆవశ్యకత ఎంతైనా ఉంది. నౌ కమింగ్ బ్యాక్ టు ద స్కూల్, మై డియర్ చిల్డ్రన్, ద స్కూల్ రిపోర్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎక్సలెంట్, మోర్ దెన్ యువర్ సింగింగ్, మోర్ దెన్ యువర్ డ్యాన్సింగ్ అండ్ ఆల్. స్కూల్ రిపోర్ట్ చదువుతూ ఉంటే నా 62 సంవత్సరాల అనుభవంలో ఎప్పుడైపోతుందా అని ఎదురు చూసేవాళ్ళం. టుడే యాజ్ ద చిల్డ్రన్ వర్ గివింగ్ రిపోర్ట్, యాన్యువల్ రిపోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది స్కూల్ విత్ ఆల్ దట్ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ అండ్ స్పెషలీ విత్ ది అకాడమిక్స్, స్పోర్ట్స్, గేమ్స్, అదర్ యాక్టివిటీస్, సో ఇంకా ఏం చెప్తారా కొత్తగా అన్న విధంగా నాకైతే అనిపించింది. దీన్ని కూడా మీరు చెప్పనివ్వరా గట్టిగా. లెట్ అస్ గివ్ ఎ రౌండ్ ఆఫ్ అప్లాజ్ టు ద ప్రిన్సిపల్, టీచర్స్ అండ్ స్టూడెంట్స్. వన్ మోర్ నాట్ ఎనఫ్, ప్లీజ్ ప్లీజ్ లిఫ్ట్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్స్ అండ్ కంగ్రాచులేట్ ద టీమ్. గాడ్ బ్లెస్ యూ 10 ఫిలోమినాస్. గాడ్ బ్లెస్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ, ఆల్ యువర్ ఎండివర్స్. అండ్ మై డియర్ బ్రదర్స్, ఎ వర్డ్ అబౌట్ అవర్ హేస్ Hyderabad Archdiocese Education Society. We are committed for the poor, for the needy. Our slogan is no child should be deprived of education because of poverty. Complete preferential option for the poor, an integral development of the child. That's what we are committed. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, the Catholic tradition, we celebrate December 8th as Immaculate Conception, Amalodbhavi Mata. So, which is nothing but purity, purity of thoughts, purity of mind, purity of actions, purity of thought. It is working hard, and the thought is not only for myself, but I am for the other. The actions that should be witness to serving to the needy, and I want to appreciate the teachers of the school, the parents and well-wishers who have come to witness, to take part in this annual day celebrations, and to witness the performance of our students. Let me take a word to our vice chairman, Monsignor Balashevri, for being with them, because he is the man who goes ahead about the school management, the principals and the teachers and parents. Oka dikshuchiga ee school vishayallo ma agra metrasana school vishayamalannitilo ayana active ga untu andarini oka taati pai nadipistu result oriented job. It is not easy, but I would like to appreciate our vice chairman and also the treasurer Father Inaya and Father Pratap, the parish priest, who really collaborates with the school and with the father and with all the children. Varu okatiga lekapothe chaala samasyalu vastayi, manamandaram kuda shanti samadhanam lekunnal chustundi. But I appreciate you, Father Pratap, for your collaboration, Father Uday, for your friendly nature, uniting both of you, especially for the growth of our school. Once again, my dear children, I wish you all the best for the rest of your performances. Wish you all the best, teachers. God bless all your endeavors. Thank you. Continue to have a beautiful evening.
Thank you, Your Eminence, for your thought-provoking, inspiring and enriching message. We will definitely cherish your words of wisdom and look forward to applying them in our lives. I request our NCC cadets to escort our guests.
हिमालय पिघलता जा रहा है, हर पांच में से दो व्यक्तियों को पीने का साफ पानी नहीं मिलता। आज हम उन पेड़ पौधों को खोने की कगार पर है। क्या हम अपनी भविष्य की पीढ़ी को यही देने जा रहे हैं? बिल्कुल नहीं। हमारे पूर्वजों ने हमें स्वच्छ और स्वस्थ ग्रह दिया था, और हम क्या कर रहे हैं? हम अपनी भविष्य की पीढ़ी को प्रदूषित और बिगड़ी हुई धरती देने जा रहे हैं। क्या ऐसा करना ठीक होगा? सोचो, ध्यान लगा कर सोचो। हमें अपनी धरती बचानी होगी भविष्य के लिए। यह काम यहाँ नहीं होगा तो कहाँ होगा? अब नहीं होगा तो कब होगा? हम नहीं करेंगे तो कौन करेगा? तो आइए, आपके सामने हास्य नाटक प्रस्तुत करने जा रहे हैं, जिसका शीर्षक है एक सोच है जागी, जिसमें नैतिक मूल्यों को दर्शाया गया है। देखिए और आनंद लीजिए।
वोटी को यानी वाईफाई को गांव चलाने वाले थे।
ओह अच्छा अच्छा लेकिन तुम इतना जोर से क्यों बोल रही हो?
ओहो इन्हें छोड़ दो जी। वैसे मैं कैसी लग रही हूँ?
So beautiful, so elegant, just looking like a wow.
ओए होए, I'm so beautiful, so elegant, just looking like a wow.
ए पति देव।
मैंने कितनी बार कहा कि मुझे पति पति मत बुलाया करो? क्या मैं तीन पत्ती हूँ या चाय की पत्ती हूँ? Nonsense. चलो अब तुम्हें किसी से मिलाना है। ये है मिसेस कपूर।
अरे हाय, हेलो मिसेस शर्मा।
हेलो, हाउ यू आर? व्हाट अ प्रेजर सस्पेंस जी।
ओह सॉरी सॉरी जी, इसका मतलब है प्लेजेंट सरप्राइज जी।
ओए होए, नेवर माइंड जी, नेवर माइंड।
ओए मिसेस कपूर, व्हाट आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग मी?
नेवर माइंड, आई नो माइंड, आई शो यू टू माय माइंड।
अरे क्या बोले जा रही हो, उन्होंने ऐसा कब कहा?
तुम्हारे कान प्लास्टिक के हैं क्या? अभी अभी तो उन्होंने कहा नेवर माइंड। इसका मतलब मेरे पास माइंड नहीं है। अभी दिखाती हूँ मेरा माइंड। लाली, ए लाली, जरा एबीसीडी तो इन्हें सुना।
ओके मॉम, ए फॉर आलू टिक्की, बी फॉर बर्गर, सी फॉर चॉकलेट पैकेट, डी फॉर डोसा, ई फॉर एग फ्राइड राइस, एफ फॉर फ्रेंच फ्राइज, जी फॉर गोलगप्पे, एच फॉर हैदराबादी बिरयानी, आई फॉर आइसक्रीम, जे फॉर जलेबी फाफड़ा, के फॉर कुरकुरे, एल फॉर लॉलीपॉप, एम फॉर मोमोज, एन फॉर नूडल्स, ओ फॉर ऑनियन पिज्जा, पी फॉर पाव भाजी, क्यू फॉर खुबानी का मीठा, आर फॉर रोटी नहीं खाऊंगी, एस फॉर स्विगी करते हैं चलो, टी फॉर तंदूरी चिकन, यू फॉर उपमा, वी फॉर वड़ा पाव, डब्ल्यू फॉर वाइट पास्ता, एक्स फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव, वाई फॉर योगर्ट, जेड फॉर जोमैटो जिंदाबाद।
आ मम्मी, हाउ मेनी टाइम्स आई एम टेलिंग कॉल मी मॉम? ओएमजी,
ओहो मॉम, मैं कच्चे में गिर गया।
ओ बेबी,
फेंका सो। अजी सुनो।
हाँ सुनते,
जल्दी आओ बाहर, मॉर्निंग शो चले जाता।
अजी काई को इतना पुकारे जी, इनका तो रोज का है।
और ये क्या है?
आई क्या बातें कर रहे जी, तुम जरा देख के बात करो। तुम्हारी लाली से कुरकुरे का पैकेट इधर डाली।
हेलो, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल, आपके दादा थवल। देखिए देखिए, यहाँ तितली के लिए तैती लड़ाइयाँ हो रही है।
तलो तलो, इनसे पूछते हैं इस बाले में यहाँ क्या हो रहा है।
व्हाट आइडल, सुबह से शाम दिस सोनली गोइंग, शी टेल शी इज फेकिंग एंड शी टेल शी इज फेकिंग, हू फेकिंग, हू नोस, यू नो, आई नो, दोनों दोनों।
मस्त रहा मस्ती में, आग लगे बस्ती में, ये आजकल के बच्चों को कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता, चाहे पूरी दुनिया इधर की उधर हो जाए, स्नैप आ रीला स्टेटस आ डालना नहीं छोड़ेंगे। अरे देखो ये भी शुरू हो गए। अरे चलो अम्मा, अरे चलो अम्मा, मेरे को देर हो रही, दुकान को जाना है, तैयार होना है।
आई देर हो रही तो तुम तैयार हो, मेरे पीछे नहीं क्यों पड़ रहे जी?
अजी अम्मा खाना वाला डालते है कि नहीं? और एक बात पहले ही बोल रहा हूँ, खाने में क्या पकाना ये लको पूछो।
अच्छा जान दो जी, ये सब छोड़ो, खाने में क्या पकाऊं जी?
अजी पागल हो गए क्या तुम, ये नको पूछो बोला ना मैं।
ठीक है जी।
अच्छा कम से कम सालन क्या बनो बोलो जी।
मेरा भेजा फ्राई नको करो। तुम्हारा खाना तुम्हारे कुछ मुबारक। मैं पैराडाइज की बिरयानी मंगा के खा लेता हूँ।
अजी तुम कितने अच्छे हैं जी।
हाँ क्या हो ना काई को इतना मस्का लगा रहे।
मेरे को भी बिरयानी का पार्सल भेज दो ना जी।
मालूम था तुम यही बोलते बोल के। तुम्हारे बाबा कट्टे कट्टे दिए थे क्या।
ओए, कोई भी इधर से नहीं लेगा। अपन के खोपड़ी फिर जा रही है। कोई कहीं नहीं जाना जब तक ये कचरे की किरकिरी खत्म नहीं होगी।
क्यों एमसीएच वाले नहीं आते रोज। वे ले जाएंगे कचरा। आई हौले होगे क्या जी। कचरे वाले तुम्हारे घर का कचरा पॉकेट में नहीं ले जाते। उन लोग पैसे लेते पैसे।
अरे पागला है जी सब लोग। पैसा दे के कचरे को लेके जाओ बोल रहे।
एक आइडिया है जी। एक काम करेंगे ये कचरे को नाले में फेंक देंगे।
क्या बछड़े को नाले फेंक देंगे। अरे इनके कान की दुकान बंद हो गई। जरा खोल लो।
ओहो वीर जी तुसी बिना कन्विच मशीन तो लगा लो। कचरे को नाले में फेंक देंगे।
ओहो मगर ये नाला तो आगे जाकर नदी से मिलता है ना। तब तो नदी का पानी खराब हो जाएगा। अब किस रास्ता है। हम ये कचरे को जला देंगे। ना रहेगा कचरा ना रहेगी ये रोज रोज की जिक जिक।
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water, but all the water had dried up. The world was now much hotter. So Jack and Jill sat on the hill. Their throats were so dry, they couldn't find a drop to drink. And one day, neither will I. मछली जल की थी रानी, जीवन उसका था पानी, पर पानी में प्लास्टिक फेंकते रहे हम, मछली को तड़पते हुए बस देखते रहे हम। धीरे धीरे मर गए मछलियां सारी, रह गए बस फेंकी हुई चीजें हमारी। ट्विंकल ट्विंकल लिटिल स्टार, हाउ आई वंडर व्हाट यू आर। अप अबाउट द स्मॉगी स्काई I have never seen you. I wonder why the smoke it makes my chest so tight. For every breath I must fight.
So mummy and daddy, uncles and aunties, ध्यान दीजिए, आपके बचपन की favorite poems बदल जाएगी, क्योंकि आप जो कचरा जलाने के बारे में सोच रहे हैं ना, उसके धुएं से ही pollution बढ़ जाएगा। हमारा बचपन क्लाइमेट चेंज की वजह से बदल रहा है। इससे लड़ने के लिए हमें चेंज होना पड़ेगा। तो जागो।
हाँ हाँ बच्चे सही कह रहे हैं। प्रकृति के लिए यह अच्छी सोच चाहिए।
हाँ सही बोल रहे बच्चे। गवर्नमेंट कचरा डालो बोल के दूधा और हरे डब्बे दिए ना। सच सच बोलो कचरे डालने के लिए इस्तेमाल कर रहे या दूसरे कुछ कामों को इस्तेमाल कर रहे। चलो चलो लाओ वो डब्बों को उसमें कचरा डालेंगे।
Thank you.
thank you students for the wonderful, rich and highly engaging call for collective and transformative action on a global scale to celebrate, protect and restore the planet by living sustainably in harmony with nature.
Plastic is the most hazardous waste affecting our planet. While we do understand the importance and consequence of its use, a plastic-free world not just be a choice, but let's remember it should be a commitment to our lives and for the future generations. We, the students of class 6th and 7th, are here to enlighten you on the worldwide developing problem by joining our hands to keep our planet green, the oceans blue, and the animals safe.
Let's get this party started.
आज ब्लू है पानी 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 और दिन भी सानी 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 आ जाओ
takes up to 1,000 years to decompose. So even after killing an animal, it goes on to kill many more. It was too late for these animals, and if we don't act, it will be too late for everyone. Out of 300 million tons of plastic produced annually, only 10% gets recycled. That means we have a lot to do. Let's get started.
Use now.
है मेरी जब इस पे कुर्बान। माँ की सेवा करना मैंने माँ से ही सीखा। इस माँ की ममता देखो हर दर्द अकेले सहती है। हमको सांसें देने के लिए दिन रात ये मेहनत करती है। नदियों में बहती है सागर में ढलती है। हमको छांव देती है सूरज में तपती है। ये कोई नहीं कर सकता बस माँ ही करती है। ये कोई नहीं कर सकता बस माँ ही करती है।
What a performance! Let's have a thunderous applause for the excellent message to ditch plastic. Together, let's shape a cleaner, healthier, and brighter future for all of us.
And nurtures our life is divine, and that is Mother Dharani, the mother of all, the soul of the earth, the root of all life. It cradles the earth on its heart, forming the base of the trees. The mother soil, being in danger, pleads everyone to save it. So touch the soil to your heart to sustain yourself. Here we are to present Dharani Dandalamma.
Let's go! Jana kara jana re, aye let's go! Jana kara jana re, aye let's go!
his very body, his soil. My body, your body, everybody is just a soil body. Save soil.
Thank you, children, for enlightening us about the need to conserve soil, the connector of lives, and feel a sense of personal renewal by taking time to hold what's beneath our feet into our hands. Your movements truly capture the essence of music. Music cannot only heal, but also instill in us a hope for an ideal world in the future. I request the choir to enthrall us with a song.
Today's newspaper. Oh, do you know about the brutal criminal case that happened in our own city?
Yeah, what a pathetic incident it was.
You're completely right. Every day these crimes are taking lead.
Yes, our society is going through an extremely worse phase. Due to technology, the human beings have forgotten their moral qualities.
Yes, that's true. Only morality and actions can solve these complexities.
I agree with your words. Parents should take initiative to mold their children because better human beings will make a better society.
Yes, only morality and actions can give beauty and dignity to life. Who you are, what your values are, what you stand for will be only found in yourselves through your actions.
Created this world with a lot of love, care, patience, and discipline.
God made the apple tree and narrated the story of all the apples in every seed of it. This little thought with great meanings gets emphasized as we remember an apple that fell from the tree above the head of a great scientist, Sir Isaac Newton, who made that single apple as a seed to make grow science. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. An apple had given knowledge to the world of science, and an apple had given smile to the world of health. What kind of apple are you in giving the true knowledge, moral values, and health to the world of your kids? Since you are all the apple of their eyes in seeing the world, here we display a mirror to introspect your thoughts on the values you want to nurture in your offsprings.
During my years, 1990s, when you and I would have played our life as healthy, as an apple we grew up, as a loving kid of our parents and adjustable siblings, accepting the price of a single loaf of a bread in a family of minimum 10 to 15. Our living rooms in the form of huts with not many sections of rooms, but only those four walls where we cooked, our laughter and cries to satisfy our hunger with love and joy made us. Everything made us fine. Everything made us okay. Even lack of brains made us with good health as well as good values. Just have a look on the kids born from our rooms. Are they adjustable, acceptable with the situations? Are they hearing your voice in need? Certainly a big question mark. Maybe Newton made a mistake of finding the gravity with the apple, and thus the gravity of our younger generation is falling on the apple tap and phones.
My old friend, the tall page from the calendar, is walking and talking here. Good to see you.
Friend, how's your life going there?
You see my two kids? Extraordinarily busy with phones and technologies. They are dazzling like anything, right?
Oh, your days are so modernized. I wonder even I could be born in your days.
Of course, you guys are struggling with those broken bullet cards and books are pale color. Oh, horrible. Just see my darlings. They are enjoying a colorful life. You people were like lazy cattle gazing for communicating with each other and no knowledge of the world around. And we have our Uncle Google who runs after us with all the facts in a single click. I am so happy with my techno kids, my two kids.
Student. All the time she wants me to be with these books, these lifeless books. Let me relax with my headphones.
Swiggy has saved my life from my mom's cooking. Thank God.
Fiona, can you give me a glass of water?
Can't you see, Grandma? I'm busy right now.
Don't disturb the kids. If you walk and take water, you won't die. Look at this generation. They don't have respect towards elders.
Who's that? It's my friend, Mom.
Hey, Jessica. What's up?
Mom, don't forget to get my report card signed by Dad.
Yeah, sure. I will see to it.
I'm tired of this traffic, Rosie. What dinner can you serve me?
Sorry, Kevin. I'm busy watching my new web series. It's there ready on the table. There are reports too on the table. Just sign them.
Reports? What reports? As usual, with low marks.
What am I to do? They never listen to me. All the time busy with their phones.
Cha, I'm fed up of these kids. I don't want to take these tensions to my mind. I need to be stress-free. Let me scroll my phone for some time.
Is too busy. They live separate in the same house. Don't they spend time with each other and care for each other? All are busy with their hobbies. Don't they take any measures to advise your kids and teach them some moral values?
Advice? Ha ha ha! Who is ready to lend for your advice? Why should we need it? Useless. You see, we run short of time achieving our goals, creating power to travel to the space. How come you expect us to waste our time in chatting?
I agree your improvised lifestyle made with quick technologies to save time. Even after walking for miles to deliver a single message, we 1990s made possible to spend time towards each other. Not the tasty recipes that made us grow healthy. Perhaps the guidance and the counsel of our elders.
The kids of our days are much advanced. They never wait for anybody's suggestion. The talents run faster equal to the towers of the internet.
Look at your generation. They are depressed, no value of life and lack of concentration. I blame neither your kids nor your parents. For sure, your initiatives have brought drastic development in the world. They are necessary for a modern world. At the same time, technologies have some corner to turn your kids spoil themselves. We can never say that it is not possible to change a track, for possibilities are not with time, they are with love.
Okay, Grandpa.
you fetch some water for me?
Okay, Grandma.
Children, children, where are you?
Mama.
You can do your work. We will take care of the children.
Yeah, kids, I brought something for all of you.
Papa, Papa.
Take Shirley and give them. Mama, Papa, how was your day?
It was fine, Beta.
How was your day, Beta? It was good, Papa.
Did you have something?
No, I will have it later. Let me spend some time with you.
Look back to my kids of 1990s. They never had cell phones to bridge themselves as an island. They had no awareness of search engines because they found everything they searched, what they needed, within those four walls called home, made of love, care, and discipline necessary for life.
The stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits of a plant are from the root of it. They listen to what the root says. And the responsible root very well knows what to offer for each of its parts. Being a human, your eyes will see the way you want. Your legs will walk the way you want. Then, why not your kids fall into the line you draw? For they are none but your own flesh and blood. The new flesh and blood, the new sapling of yours, before a new life could enter your life, start straightening up yourself. Because you are their first visitors. They eat by your hands and walk by your legs. They are wings waiting at your hands to find them to flutter. They are toddlers in the hand at your feet to discover their path. Once they began to mission their life, you can no longer stop them. A company to guide them before they are out of your circle. Taking pride in getting everything for your kids is not the beauty of real parent. Starving is also a lesson that will make the kids understand the life better. Never create a comfortable material zone for your kids, but take the efforts to build a comfortable life zone to adjust, accept, and act according to their needs. Every child given to you is a second chance to succeed in the experiment of life. Let our eyes close from the world, leaving another set of eyes to see the beauty of life, where you ripe as a wonderful apple of the branches. Let all the seeds of apple be wise and healthy to create many more virtuous apples, and hence our generation will be a garden of healthy apples with the lovely chirping of birds as music for our life. Thank you.
heart-touching and sentimental performance, for true treasures are not found in material wealth, but in the values passed down through generations and interwoven relationships between parents and the children.
Let's brace ourselves for another magnificent performance that showcases our dedication and passion, which shines to our every note, step, and brushstroke. Here, we are the Electric Enigma.
Zubaan se
you, children, for your energetic performance. It was truly spectacular. You have set the stage on fire.
Court, our chief guest, Monsignor Reverend Father Bala Shaureddy, accompanied by our HM, to come forward and do the honors. Let's all give them a huge round of applause. Request our chief guest to kindly come on to the dais. Now it's time to acknowledge all the students who have scored 10 GPA in 5 subjects. Yashashvini, now it's time to acknowledge the students who have scored 10 GPA in 3 subjects, and I call upon Azra Mubin, E. Manasa, Kirtana, Lavanya, Sri Pradvini, M. Yashashvini, N. Kirtana. Now I call upon the students who have scored 10 GPA in 2 subjects. Amina, Anamika, Bushra, Snehaswini, Vaishnavi, G. Sahitya, D. Shivani, D. Akshaya, K. Tanmay. Now I call upon the students who have scored 10 GPA in 1 subject. G. Rakshita, Saima, Maria Divya, Mary Sheba, Suhana, Ashvita, Hanshika, Vanshika, Iram Yonas, E. Bhargavi, Sara Fatima, M. Vaishnavi, R. Vaishnavi, Hasmat, Priyanshu, Mahin, Lahari, Durga Janavi, Charanya, Charanya Spandana. I also call upon Tanushri of grade 10, who secured gold medal in CM KCR Mega Cup National Level Karate and Kung Fu Championship, silver medal in Open Hyderabad Karate Championship, and bronze medal in South India Open Karate Championship. Thank you, Montigno. Let's give them a huge round of applause. I request our dignitaries to be seated on the dais. We are delighted to be Shekhar, who has demonstrated exceptional leadership skills and has truly made a difference. He has also been an exemplary figure in his field and achieved remarkable success. We request you, sir, to kindly come on to the dais and share some words of wisdom.
Good evening, our esteemed chief guest, parents, and my dear students. This evening, it reminded me of my journey then till today. I would like to share this, the journey. I'll not take much of time because I think it stands still relevant today, what I underwent, and I'm at this stage. This long journey I can describe in just three letters, that is God. Simply God. G-O-D. My definition, my second definition of God is goals, opportunities, and destination. I believe in this. You all must have heard that everybody gets an opportunity. Opportunity knocks the door, is it? So, when opportunity is there, it is how you utilize it. And the education institute, that is the schools, they provide you the basic stage for reaching that opportunities and your journey to the goals. So, while you're traveling from your goals and the destination, there are many things which you have to undergo. Like, you have to be determined in what you are doing. There has to be devotion in what you are doing. Then, while doing all this, you will definitely get across many things which are not walking your way. There will be definitely irritants, distress, differences which come across
every moment, every second. But you should not get perturbed. In fact, those should be taken as a lesson and you should work on it and overcome all those. So, destiny goals can be reached with your opportunities and the hard work which you put. The school has given you that opportunity. I only request even the parents, you play a very important role in children's reaching their goals, achieving their goals, reaching their destination. You need to be a ladder for them. You need to be a support for them, like my parents were till now. So I request the parents to be a support to your kids, to your children, to allow them to flourish, to allow them to take their own steps and perform what they want to. Secondly, today in the evening, the kids have presented an excellent show with various messages. So I would like to request the students and the parents not to stop here. The message should not die on this stage. The message should go to across the boundaries of this school. The message should go to everyone, every person, wherever you go. Try to spread that so that we can build a better future for ourselves, our kids, and we have a heavenly earth. Lastly, I would like to thank the principal and the staff for giving me the opportunity once again to be the part of this event, and thank and congratulate the entire staff for putting up this excellent show. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your enlightening and valuable message. I request our guests to retreat to their seats.
In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. The choir will now present, "Thank You, Lord." Thank you, children, for your incredible performance. You and your band was truly amazing.
Around us and within us, it just takes a little focus to observe and embrace the beauty of God's creation. Every creature is an embodiment of God's creation. Every element that He has incorporated into this planet holds its own unique value, worth, and importance. Here we are, class and students, to portray the same through our performance.
Na kaato
समस्या आओ सुलझाए इसे मिलकर हम
emphasizing the need to give ourselves the gift of living well in agreement with nature as it is our own. Thanks to everything that happens in our lives, knowing that every step forward is towards achieving something bigger and better. I now call upon Bala Jyotika, our SPL, to propose the vote of thanks.
Human emotions. To speak gratitude is courteous and pleasant. To enact gratitude is generous and noble. But to live with gratitude is to touch heavens. A pleasant and delightful evening to one and all gathered for this wonderful evening. I feel honored and privileged to express words of gratitude for your presence with us this evening. Firstly, we raise the hearts to the Almighty for his countless blessings on all of us throughout this celebration. This day has indeed been special. By the gracious presence of our esteemed chief guest, His Eminence Cardinal Pula Anthony. His Eminence, your charismatic presence amidst a busy schedule and your inspiring message have lifted high the spirit of this event. We express our deep sense of gratitude to our guest of honor, Monsignor Reverend Father Bala Shavreddy, for your presence on this auspicious day. Thank you very much, Father. Gratitude inspires happiness, and true happiness that flows is highly inspired. We express our heartfelt thanks to our esteemed guest, Lieutenant Colonel K.V. Shekhar, for your presence and support. We extend our gratitude to thank our headmaster, Reverend Father Uday Bhaskar, for his unwavering support and coordination, which helped us to make this event an extraordinary and remarkable memory. I feel delighted to express my thanks to all the Reverend Fathers and dedicated sisters for your presence with us this evening. I also thank our beloved ex-teachers for your presence today. I thank all the choreographers for your creative inputs and sincere efforts. We thank all the parents for your support and cooperation. A note of thanks to all the... We thank Andrew Sir and Joseph Sir for the expertise and meticulous planning, arrangements and execution in organizing the program. An event such as this wouldn't have been successful without the sacrifice of time and energy by our faculty. We thank you, dear teachers, for your tireless efforts in perfecting every aspect of this program. I owe my special gratitude to the administrative staff and supporting staff for your selfless contribution. I thank my dear shining stars of St. Philomena for your colorful and entertaining performances. Thank you and God bless.
A very good evening to everyone. I hope you all enjoyed. So once again, I thank all the participant students who perform excellently well. A very good review from the chief guests, priests, sisters, they are already appreciating your performance. And also a big hats off to all the staff who worked behind the curtain preparing the children. So congratulations, teachers and students, for your wonderful performance. And I also congratulate all our outgoing 10th class students who secured 10 points in various subjects. I wish and pray that you excel in your future. Good. You will excel in your future, yeah. I also thank all the parents for your support, cooperation, and for your presence. Thank you, parents, for being here. Once again, wishing you all a good day and good night. And tomorrow will be the study holiday for all the children. Study holiday tomorrow. And we will all meet you on Monday. Thank you. God bless you all.
We have come.
Thank you and God bless you all.